Wake up! Hey, wake up! The sun's frying your butt! The family has invited the crew to the Radiant Feldspar as witnesses for an important meeting.
Oh my god, I was muted, I was talking to myself while my mic was muted. Literal Delulu behavior.
Leaving as soon as you're ready.
Oh damn, we're leaving. Already? Well, then let's say farewell to the best sorry out of Genshin and Star Rail.
Plus this fancy button model.
Oh
after
no.
After you're back on your feet, you can enjoy them all.
That is not the Iris family, March. That is someone else. A racist, if you might say. Oh? Switching POVs? If we switch POVs, I wonder who are we getting? Oh, are we not switching POVs? Oh yeah, oh wow, I wonder who we're switching the POV to.
No problem, Miss Samuel. I love this fake name.
Miss Samuel. Oh, I love her.
Now that we're done here, I hear the Genius Society is here. How about we go stir up some excitement?
Of course she'd wanna fuck with the Genius Society.
Well, you know, my script isn't over yet.
Yeah.
But also receive an unforgettable reward on the planet of festivities.
God, I can't wait to see what it is.
How will I know if I don't try?
Temptation will show up again in Penacony.
Damn, he's so poetic.
You know me.
Blade is worried. Yeah, it's such a father-daughter relationship between those two. It's amazing.
Or maybe I'll give it to Blade. He'll appreciate it.
Aww, that's adorable.
That's not written in the script, right? But as you see, I have added new footnotes to my destiny.
Damn. She really is pushing forward. Switching to... Oh, really? We are back to the feds?
When the big boss arrives, please remind her to be cautious and watch out for any traps.
I think Jade is gonna be cautious either way.
Thank you for the reminder, but I don't think that will be necessary. When she's at the table, it's the others who need to be cautious.
Yeah, most likely.
Just tell everyone on our team to stay focused.
You know, since she's following the path of voracity, probably. Family's guard.
How many centuries would it take to press them all?
Huh, damn, I wonder who this family guard is. Huh. We're finally getting some sparkle though. The fact that no one pushed those buttons is probably the most unrealistic part of this game.
The Charmony Festival, originally scheduled at the Penacony Grand Theater, had to be temporarily postponed.
I wonder if we're actually, like, gonna get anything about the Charmony Festival until the 3.0 update. Or if that is gonna be, like, forever, it's gone. No more Charmony Festival.
So, Mr. Alfalfa suggested relocating the Charmony Festival to the Radiant Feldspar.
Well, I shouldn't have asked. Hey, she's here.
In my opinion, you handled that project quite well.
Snake lady.
A little ball of ice in exchange for the Astral Express's good favor. That's not a bad deal for the department. It's been a while, little Yelena.
Yelena?
I've been looking forward to working with you. Never imagined this day would come so soon. Is there trouble? You can tell me anything. Just like old times.
Oh, this woman smells like trouble.
It's been a while, Madam Jade. I'm honored to have
and probably really expensive perfume, but still. Definitely trouble.
You are a senior.
She's such a simp.
Well.
Martin, charming ladies.
Okay, I'm guessing he's from the Lofu.
Please, have a
or at least a long life species.
Let's have a pleasant conversation. Sure you've figured out the topic I'd like to discuss, yes?
Future of Penacony?
The future of Penacony, if I'm not mistaken.
I was right.
Precisely. Let's take that golden-haired guy who's not showing up, for example. He put in great effort.
Oh, yeah, wait.
But what was it all for?
I almost forgot. Woodhill is holding Aventurine at gunpoint right now. Oh, wait, what's happening there?
Wasn't it eventually to create an opportunity for you IBC to regain control of the precious Astana?
Please, I hope they're not getting Penacony. The IPC is so bad in this game. Like, the IPC is so bad in this game. For every planet that they save is probably another one that they throw into ruin. For every good thing they do, there is a barn that's burning down and killing the adoptive daughter of a guy. If you didn't know what I'm saying, it's basically Boothill's story.
My actions will help Penacony take a significant step forward by self-listing and going public.
Damn, that's a strategy. I mean, if you go public, they literally don't have anything that they can hold against you.
And go public on a universal scale.
Oh, or that.
I'd prefer to open the doors of the sweet dream to the entire universe.
So that means no more stowaways, because stowaways will be like a thing of the past.
Every move we make will be scrutinized by trillions of people.
That's the point.
To respond on behalf of the IPC later.
Okay, so yeah, they're probably gonna try to do something. Hey, we're back here.
Either the family or IPC were to assume full control of Penacony, it would return to its previous illusory dream of hedonism, and the efforts of those previous nameless would once again go to waste.
Oh, okay. So we should try to avoid the power from going into the hand of only one group. Yeah, it's almost like real life.
There you are. Did you rest well?
Like a rock. And what about Sunday? Yeah, what is he doing?
Face a trial. As for further details, the family would rather not disclose them.
Hmm. There's no way he escapes unscathed out of that trial. Could it be that the theory about Sunday joining the Stellaron Hunters is true? Imagine if that would change the status quo of this game so much. Like him joining the Stellaron Hunters and Firefly living with the Astral Express. Like, god, that would be awesome. Oh my god, this is strong as shit, sweet as shit, and thick as shit. God damn it, dude. This thing here is like a mouthful of cum. Of sweet cum. That was the worst comparison I've ever made in my life. I'm going to delete my channel. What have you been up to? That sticker. It's a secret for now. Oh? I'm Aventurine, please show me what's happening to my guy.
No need.
Is he gonna get
I'll
shot?
Alone.
Hello? Wait. Come on. Agree to my conditions. Come on. Come on. Say harder. You bitch. Oh my god, this is the worst. Okay, let's stay.
Thank you for your patience.
Let's debate him. Debate.
Let's
continue. Negotiate.
Keep tearing down and rebuilding this place until the Asdana system gets used to the IPC's ways again.
As I said, for every good thing they do something like this. Who the fuck says this and is not like a bad guy?
30% equity, you say? Who can guarantee you won't want more in the future?
Yeah. I don't know how much they actually give a shit about their interests.
Please, Topaz, invite Sweet Dew to join us at the table.
Sweet Dew? What? Oh, wait, what? Himeko is working with them?
Thank you for your presence, Miss Himeko.
Damn.
One of the future shareholders of Penacony.
Jesus Christ. Can Himeko stop girl bossing? Like, you're getting a little bit too close to the sun.
Now that my business is done, it's time for me to indulge in my own little hobby.
Okay, why is that put in bold? What is she gonna do?
A Bonnet Jade exchange branch on this ship too?
Oh, okay. Oh, switching to Firefly. Yeah, I'm the... she's the final guest, right? Wait, or is it us?
Pawn shop that grants wishes. Is there really a place like that on the ship?
Then...
I'll find out for myself if the rumors are true or not.
Ah, yes. Waterfall.
Is that... her?
Yeah! Follow her!
Huh. Can I ask you something?
Firefly. Ah, yes. Character AI moment. I just outed myself, eh? Why are... Look at the shack. What the hell? That's not how shadows work. What? Where are the shadows broken? Wait, this is not a pawn shop. Oh no, we're gonna get whipped, aren't we?
Welcome to Bonnet Exchange, Radiant Feldspar Branch.
I want to keep on living. And for that?
Oh no, please.
To give up
Firefly, no! No! Come on, don't go. Don't do
everything
this.
Everything you have.
That's right. Everything.
You don't have anything of equal value to offer.
Damn, that's savage. Literally calling her useless.
Go and talk to these people. They're all customers of my pawn shop. See for yourself if their wishes have come true.
I mean, it's better if she doesn't make a deal with
Jade. Once you've done that, come back to me. I'll help you understand the true meaning of pawn.
Sorry. I'll catch up with you later.
We can't go and talk with... Well... Her? Me? Myself? Okay, yeah, whatever. Let's keep going. This is confusing.
Alright. Let's see what you've got.
Oh. Alright. Ah yes, match 3. Just the thing that I wish to do right now. 20-0. Damn. Instant heal.
I won? I actually won!
This can't be.
Okay, what did she give up to win?
10 times in a row.
Will you go out with me? I will.
Yay, everyone clap for Del. My guy raised her up.
Trying to learn everything about me. So yes, I will.
Yeah, look at this, guys. Just pay attention. Pay fucking attention and maybe you'll get some reason. I mean, I'm saying that as the most reasonless motherfucker, but... Hey.
Never thought it'd end up like this. Right here.
What is the satisfaction, though? Like, you didn't catch it. Jade told you.
So you're back, Miss Samuel.
Okay, let's see why she has nothing to offer.
Yeah. I found those people. And it seems their wishes did come true after visiting the Bonnet Jade Exchange.
He put up his entire fortune in exchange for a gift that would impress Dorothy.
You stupid motherfucker. She literally... Yeah, Elry's... Fucking hell. She literally told you that she just wanted you to pay attention to her. And, like, pay attention to what she likes. You stupid, stupid little shit.
A lady with a gambling addiction.
Me for
she
real.
She wanted some serious luck. I took away all her close relationships.
I mean, she's a gambling addict. She's gonna lose them anyways. Oh my god, that's dark. I'm sorry.
As for Detective Walker. He spent 2 decades chasing down a wanted criminal. His memories as a detective will be erased, and he will completely forget his own identity and all the sacrifices he has made.
Jesus Christ, this is the worst one. Firefly?
So now, do you understand what you must give up, Miss Samuel? Or should I address you as...
Firefly or Stellaron Hunter Sam?
AR-26710. A remnant of Glamoth's iron.
Oh, you piece of shit. You could have chosen any other name. That must sting.
I'm not surprised.
You are
are much calmer than I expected. Entropy loss syndrome. Truly an unjust misfortune, isn't it?
Don't take anything from her. Just go to Ruan Mei. She'll probably help you. She might have tried to recreate an emanator of the swarm, but it's better than this.
The people who know the secret and can cure the disease are nowhere to be found.
Oh, so it was curable? Oh, that sucks even more. If her disease actually had a cure, but now it was lost to time.
Are you suggesting that the IPC has a remedy? So you're going to ask me to personally restrain my partners to ensure my own survival?
Unfortunately, that's not quite the case.
Oh, no, okay.
Partners, a nice way to put it. Now I'm even more curious about the Stellaron Hunters. Each of you has your own identity and a special bond with each other. It's strong and intimate, and yet it allows for independence.
Yeah, they're like a family.
If all Stellaron Hunters are like you...
They're a bit more eccentric, I'd say, but yeah, they're pretty cool as well.
Attempting to move in the opposite direction.
Yeah, so they do follow finality.
I really hope that one day, all of you will come and visit my pawn shop. I'll be waiting patiently for that day.
Let's hope it never happens.
Can I see this as an invitation? From Diamond to the Stellaron Hunters while keeping the IPC in the dark?
Oh.
She could let the entirety of Pierpoint know about it within a few mere seconds.
Finally, we're getting something. She's being cool. Fuck yeah.
What drives you to take such a risk and extend this invitation on behalf of Diamond? Even if it could lead to your downfall.
Simply put, you and I are the same.
Okay, Mahito.
Well, it ends with hope.
Hope. That's a funny thing.
Lady Bonajade? I've come to deliver the collaterals promised.
Oh, damn. That's... Hey, Boot Heel!
Don't worry, I hate cheating on the table.
Wait, they resolved this? I hope you have... Yeah, have fun, guys.
Thank you.
You know.
How are you?
It has been pretty long, actually. Life is as wonderful as ever. Dead tired. In the mood for a job change. Somewhere in between ending it all and fuck it, we ball. We are so fucking back. Yeah, that's where I am right now. Wonderful as ever.
That's what I thought.
Are you also able to transform yourself? What? I see occasion. Oh my god, no. No! We are getting Genshin dialogue. Please. Star Rail, don't fall into that, please. We got Genshin dialogue, my guys. It's Jover. Himeko. Wait, that's not Himeko. That's Argenti. Is he not gonna have a voice actor again? Why isn't Argenti voiced? When will I be able to unlock a new path then? You just unlocked the harmony, you ungrateful bitch. Yeah, let's relax.
The festival hasn't started. Let's take a quick break.
Hi, we meet again.
Hey, she's
Who's
her.
That?
Who's that?
It's really you. I knew I didn't get the wrong person.
You mistook someone else for me?
It was you. I saw you opening treasure chests, hitting balloons, and playing dreamy slots. I don't think I'm mistaken, right?
Nah, that sounds like the raccoon behavior that
There's
she has.
There's still some time before the Charmony Festival starts. Do you want to chat?
I mean, if you insist.
She told me her price, but...
Don't take the deal.
I know. But what she wanted wasn't my answer either.
What did she want?
Of course, I want to...
Oh yeah, I fucking forgot to talk with everyone.
What fate owes me? I want it paid back.
Damn, that's hard.
Between me and fate.
That's like every Stellar and Hunter.
Actually, I feel that I still owe you a formal apology for that matter with the performer of the Iris family.
Oh wait, she lied. Oh, this, no big deal. I mean, it's probably better than just going around and being like, hey, I am Sam, the Stellar and Hunter. I create purgatory.
I'm sorry.
Never felt hurt, no problem. You shouldn't have lied to me in the beginning. Yeah, I didn't really care.
Really?
It's that girl! Get moving! Arrest
before
the Harmony Festival's opening ceremony starts!
Looks like we have to say our goodbyes. Don't worry about me, just go and enjoy the ceremony.
Are we never going to get, like, some sweet time with her? Really? It will always be cut short like this?
We will meet again.
Godspeed, Firefly. Marry me! I am Robin's lapdog!
The father of Penacony, Mikhail Charred Legwork, one of the legendary nameless who laid the foundations of Penacony.
They are finally putting some respect on his name. This best crew would have been disbanded long ago if it weren't for you. What the fuck? That is... What? Why is she so nice all of a sudden? I wanna see how she reacts though. Yeah, you are the glue that holds us together.
Obviously. Wait, why does that seem so ominous?
On behalf of all family members throughout the cosmos, offer a token of appreciation to the nameless.
Of course Dan Hung is not here. He probably wouldn't like all of this.
We will transfer ownership of the Radiant Feldspar.
Holy shit!
Express. A meager appreciation that we hope you will accept with grace.
A meager appreciation? My god, that's not small. Oh, it's because of Himeko, isn't it? She pulled the strings and she has like 5% of Penacony. I guess this counts.
Let us gift our applause and cheers to these brave and dauntless nameless.
Holy!
Nameless!
Yeah!
And now,
we're fucking rich!
To Harmony, to the Trailblaze, to the future of Penacony and the universe, and to the generous Alfalfa family head, Mr. O.T. Alfalfa.
Yeah, let's go!
Cheers!
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 Oh, something bad. No. It's a cutscene. Something bad is gonna happen.
Make a decision like that. This little bird is no less capable than her brother.
As well. Right. But have you forgotten someone, my gray-haired friend? I put a bomb on this ship. You have 10 minutes to
run. Oh, monodrama.
When did this get shoved into my hands?
Fast.
There's still so many bombs.
Doesn't matter when. Report the situation. What? Let's go! No, it's not let's go, let's go!
Let's start following the plan.
He's staring right at you. Stare back. The door continues to stare. Continues to stare. That has never been honest if it would be quite unsettling. Like, you expect to utter a single word? Keep staring! Can I... Oh, I did something. I thought it would stare like I could go like for hours. Asterically. Wait. I just wanna tell you. Wait, is this fucking never gonna give you up? Oh my god. Oh god. This is a re-crawl. Oh my god. Sparkle just re-crawled us. Jesus Christ, this is the worst shit ever. I wanna tear that thing to shreds. Blowing a kiss. Okay, did we find all of them? Or are we missing like one or two? Good news, we found the remaining dolls, but there are also just dolls. What's going on? There are actually 1,000 dolls on the Radiant. This place, when we catch her, we'll definitely teach her a lesson she won't soon forget. Yeah, we have a pool, so...
Not much time left.
We have a pool, so we can probably waterboard her if we want. Oh no. Not again. Last time Firefly was standing in front of us alone, she got stabbed through the chest. No. It is the scene. Fuck. How's the bomb situation?
Looks like she also sent you a message. Since you're here, I'll just keep it short. Just over half an hour ago, I received a message from an unknown sender and rushed here as soon as I could.
Mommy, I don't wanna die. Am I saying this to Firefly? Press that. Oh no.
Actually, there might be another way.
Oh?
Do you still remember? The script said that I will experience death 3 times in the land of dreams.
Oh, don't. Death and killing yourself are 2 different things.
I think this moment heralds the 3rd time. I will take this bomb into the depths of the dreamscape. As deep as possible, where there are no living souls around. That way, at least no one will get hurt.
What about you? Yeah, she'll experience the 3rd death.
I believe that this Firefly armor will be enough to take me to where I need to go before the countdown ends. And maybe even make it back safely.
But that's a gamble. And you're not adventuring.
This is our best and most logical course of action. After all, a long story deserves a happy ending.
But don't you deserve a happy ending as well?
I have some words to share with you. Though they were spoken to me by Miss Acheron. She said that the so-called impossible is merely something that is yet to happen.
Yeah.
Maybe it's just that the moment to disprove these impossibilities hasn't arrived yet.
That's a nice way of looking at things. Do your thing.
Whether
take the bomb.
Be literal ending, suffering akin to death, or a harrowing deathscape. Before the appointed destination arrives, they are all the same. Yet I can still make myriad choices. I also firmly believe that when that moment arrives for us to make a choice, the answer to our end will already be within our hearts. It is not destiny that shapes us, but we who shape destiny.
Damn. It's interesting that they follow the finality.
The Astral Express and the Stellaron Hunters are like light and shadow. We walk on different paths, intertwined, moving forward and growing together. Maybe the end is predestined, but it is not today.
Going too well. Let's speed up the countdown.
Human life is short, just like fireflies to a flame. So if you have an answer in your heart, always remember, don't leave with any regrets. We have this right.
About other people's safety. Why don't you go take a closer look?
Oh, damn!
You see, everything is possible in this land of dreams.
She saved us!
We each came here with our own goals and realized them in unimaginable ways. Regardless,
this
if the
is
result
adorable.
Was a sweet illusion, or a bitter reality. It was an answer we longed for, day and night. So, why do people choose to slumber?
think it's as you said. Because in the end, we will wake up from our dreams.
Damn, she took us from a flight. She took us for a flight. Literally swept us off our feet. Uh-oh. Oh, she's just paying respects, I guess. Damn, that was sweet. It was a bit short. If that's the ending, it was a bit shorter than the other update. But it was pretty great.
Penacony, as you hoped, has welcomed the dawn after a long, dark night.
Welcome the dawn after a long, dark night? Damn. Really not beating the previous German the Hunter joke I made in the last video. I think this is the most fitting. Say goodbye to the old nameless. A toast.
Brooklyn Tiernan, Rosalina, Jay, and Estella. We raise a toast to you, trailblazers of the Silver Rail. A toast to history that no longer remains silent. The passionate and courageous pursuit and a voyage that traverses the stars.
Cheers. Wait, what is this? Bid farewell to Gallagher.
That statue. It wasn't here last time. He's an enigmatic character for sure.
You're proud of yourself for that, aren't you? He was a great friend in the end. A toast. For Gallagher.
Gallagher, we raise a toast to you, the slumbering hound.
Let's go raise a toast to Misha as well. Say goodbye to Mikhail, or Misha. Yeah. We'll still trailblaze for you. Bid farewell. A toast. To Mikhail.
Mikhail Char Legwork, we raise a toast to you. Watchmaker of the Land of the Dreams. Nameless of the Astral Express.
But those things are all in the past.
Oh no. Is she getting existential dread or something? You're awfully sentimental today. Oh, Jesus Christ, that last one is the worst thing ever. Treasure the present. Look towards the future.
I know.
You won't be affected as long as you don't live vicariously through them. Why is the third one always like the asshole option? No matter what, that's very hard to accept. Yeah.
Because we've seen every nook and cranny of their lives, we see these people as special. So, even if there are parts of it that aren't really realistic, nor logical, we still hope that their story gets a good ending when it comes.
Damn, that's a bit self-aware.
When Mr. Mikhail sat in this chair, waiting for the Astral Express to arrive every day, what was he thinking? And if, at the end of his life, he could still firmly say he had no regrets...
Why is this hitting March so hard out of everyone?
Then, what is this regret we feel in our hearts right now?
The universe may not remember every person who leaves a tie along the Silver Rail. But we will.
But we will. Oh. Why did that make me tear up? What the fuck?
As long as we remember, their stories will never end.
You know, I was gonna say come on. Let's go. Let's say goodbye to her as well. Like, she doesn't deserve to be left hanging. Like, she helped us so much in this. Without her, we've probably been dead like 3 times already.
I am convinced that my destination lies within the depths of the dark web, where reality and the nihility are separate.
Where reality and nihility are separate.
In there lurks a secret called Device 9.
Device IX, yeah.
I'll reach it.
Oh, I saw a tip about this while I was playing in the simulated universe.
In your opinion, what does this déjà vu mean?
Perhaps some sort of sentimental attachment? a longing for a certain someone, the wish to return to the past. I don't know. I think this is the most fitting answer.
Attachment, desire, longing. They may all be right, but they are all incomplete. I believe it's not something external, but something that originates within us. An emotion that traverses time from a certain moment of our past to reach us. And I believe it will still bloom at the end of the nihility. Until we meet again beneath the sun's rays.
Oh, this is from back when she was Raiden. Or Mei. Why is Pom Pom crying?
Don't be sad. Don't cry.
Wow. Your method of consolation is truly unsophisticated.
Don't shit on her, at least she's trying something.
Still better than just standing there like a scarecrow.
That's what I said!
Pom Pom is just angry! It's not because of Fisha, Tiernan, Rosalina, and the rest!
Yeah, definitely, I can sense that. Me, an empath, understanding that Pom Pom is just angry. Pom Pom said we might run out of fuel.
Well, they were a little emotional at the time, but I'm afraid that's not out of the question.
Oh, so wait, how do we refuel the express?
Want to become an ice cube floating around in space again?
At least you'll be an adorable ice cube.
When you put it like that, doesn't actually sound too bad.
Wow, complimenting her goes a long way, right?
Still requires a vote.
So will we be able to vote and choose the next
or
one?
Or perhaps you might consider a suggestion.
Oh, Black Swan.
We meet again.
So is she actually joining us? Wait, could it be that we've been bamboozled again in some way? I'm being paranoid, probably.
Have you all considered this? Perhaps your destination could be a world that even the renowned Akivili never reached.
Oh, okay, that's a good idea.
Should you be able to lay down a new stretch of silver rail, the Express may never have to worry about energy ever again. The Eternal Land, Amphorius.
Amphorius? Three pets. Jesus, that's... that's fascinating, like, every place we've been to, it's only had one path. What's happening?
I hope I'm not too late, child.
Oh no. Oh!
I wasn't expecting it to be you.
He's not joining the Stellaron Hunters. He's probably joining the IPC? Maybe? Or he's gonna be like an asset?
Would you be willing to talk to me then?
Don't talk to her, that's so dangerous, my guy. You're literally gonna be like a piece of chicken by the end of when she's done with you.
A word of warning from someone who's been in your shoes before.
Oh, is she talking about herself or?
Life is too short to miss out on golden opportunities.
Or is that... wait, is that... is she talking about a Venturine? Yeah, I guess it's done. I guess this was Penacony. Interlude. Putin has become a visitor. Robin has become a visitor. Sparkle has... okay. Black Swan? Come on. Add Firefly as well. No, she's not a visitor yet.